And we are live again. Hi everyone, hi, I'm Christian with Captain Hybrid. Welcome on today's live stream. It's, what is it? It's, Thursday already? It's Thursday, March 2nd, 2017. Hi everyone, I hope you're doing well. I hope you're having a nice sunny day like we're having here. I'm so liking the blue skies. No clouds, no anything, just sun, a little bit of warmth, not too much, but good. It's spring. Spring is coming, so that's always lovely. Yeah, the trees still need a little bit of work. They need like some flowers and some stuff. But until that happens, you know what? Let's play. Let's stay inside until it's warm enough outside. Let's stay inside a little bit and let's enjoy a new game. This is Loot Rascals, everyone. It's an adorable looking and very colorful and cute roguelike, where you have to control a character that goes searching for a certain object, and in order to reach that object, he or she has to go through all sorts of, let's say, dangerous worlds. And along the way, you fight a lot of enemies. You get you collect cards from them, cards. Okay, and you make you customize your character with those cards that you get. You can get some magical abilities. You can get extra defense, extra attack. You can get extra health. It's all very, it's all very strategic. Action-packed and strategic, because it has a little bit of action and a lot of strategy. It's turn-based, kinda, but it doesn't feel turn-based because everything's so fast-moving, which I really like. And I mean, if you look at you know, a video, that was kind of the first thing I saw with Loot Rascals, how direct everything is. It's like, oh, you do this, oh, it's turn-based, but it moves so fast and it's lovely. Hi tomato, bye. Hi and bye tomato, I guess. Hi Christopher, hello. Oh, that reminds me of that Seinfeld episode, like, hello. I miss Seinfeld, but it's, you know what, it's done, it's finished, long gone. Let's focus on the new, which is Loot Rascals. Now, although it was, I think it was planned to come out a bit earlier, like today, but I've seen on the Steam page, Loot Rascals is going to come out on March 7th, so that's next week. It's going to come out for Windows on Steam, and it's also coming out for the PlayStation 4. I did not find any link. I provided in the description a link to, you know, to the PlayStation site and where it says Loot Rascals, but I have no idea how much it cost. I'm guessing it's going to be like $15 or euro, probably like the same as the PC version. Now I'm going to play obviously on the PC. I'm not going to use the controller, although it is over here. You can play with the keyboard and mouse. I think the keyboard and mouse work really well with the Loot Rascals. Now you see you have leaderboards, but oh, there are people who already played a little bit. Oh, somebody escaped, see? A lot of people have escaped. I haven't escaped, I only reached area 2 out of 5. Cards looted. Wow, come on, I looted more cards than this person. Never mind, it's fine. It's fine, let's go back to the title and let's play. I'm going to start from the beginning. I reset my saves. Let's start... should we start with a tutorial? You know what, let's start with a tutorial so everyone gets Loot Rascals. Here you can choose your character. It's either this guy who's half man, half penis shaped spaceship, or this badass pirate woman, I guess. Ah, let's go for the pirate lady. Let's go for the pirate lady. And this is a tutorial. Let's stretch your legs. Use WSD to go around. So every time you move, a turn passes, and you can see the turns in the upper right next to your next to the minimap. There are like 5 suns and 5 moons. The idea is that each turn represents kind of a time of day and a time of night. So as soon as you move, see, as soon as you move and you go to a new location, then another turn passes. But you can move pretty fast. It's like you don't have to wait or anything like that. See, now it's night. Now I'm just going to go, and you discover more things as you go around. See the turn meter up there in the top right? That's the actual. This is actually a turn-based strategy game. Turn-based game. You wouldn't really say it because it moves so fast. Run around and watch the current turn counter change as you move between tiles. Yeah, that's pretty straightforward. You move, you explore new stuff, and yeah. Alright, Day and night are only a few turns apart. This is important because you'll get the first hit on some baddies at day and others at night. So this is very important when the time of day when you attack or when you get attacked. Well, no, actually when you attack. Some monsters will be defensive during the night and offensive during the day, and others will be, you know, the opposite, will be attacking. So at night they'll come after you, and during the day they'll, you know, move away from you, and others will be, you know, doing the exact opposite. Alright, so we have some cards. Hey, go and loot those. So every time you kill a monster, there's a chance they will drop some cards and you can loot them, because the game is called Loot Rascals, obviously. And you get these cards, you collect them, you can destroy them if you want tokens, which is kind of a, it's a currency, it's money. Basically, you're going to sell them, you're going to destroy them for money. And great, now let's equip them. Press space to open your HUD. So, like a good old card collecting game, you have your own deck and you can choose what cards to have in that deck and how you equip them. You have two rows and made up of either you can say two rows, five columns and 10 cards maximum, as you can see here, and you can choose what card to put in those slots. And positioning is important. Because, for example, this one, it's ablative armband, so it will give you one extra defense, but when this card is put in an even slot, its bonus doubles. So if I put it in one, it gets one defense. See, my character now has one defense. But if I put it in the second column, then it's an even slot and it's going to get two defense. It doubled. So it's really important how you mix and match your cards and where you position them in your deck. So let's see this one, column one. So this one gives you one attack, but if you put it in the first column, it will give you an two more attacks, so three attack. See? Then we have this one, meteor ball. If it's in the top row, it gets one extra attack. So I put this. Now we have five attack, and this one. Space shorts, card to the right, plus two. Alright, so this one will give you, will give the card to its right two extra points. And, alright, orange cards increase your attack, blue cards increase your defense, attack and defense are displayed on the top. See over here, next to my life. Alright. And, okay, so. Do you want something? Exactly? Okay, try to arrange these cards so you have 5 attack and 5 defense. Alright, so 5 attack and 5 defense. Well, I have 3 attack. Wait, let's try this. Let's put it like this. I have 5 defense. And let's put here. And we have 5 attack, 5 defense. You can get, you know, higher stats depending on how you mix and match your cards and where you position them. So positioning is important, okay? You can't just like, let's just put them around here and that works. No, you have to think a little bit about it. And, you know, and see where you put them. Alright, so now that we have the cards, and we have 5 attack and 5 defense, let's kick some ass. Alright, so combat starts when you share a tile with a baddie. So it's either you going in the tile of your enemy, or the enemy coming to your tile. And again, all of this is turn-based, right? It's automatic, you take turns attacking each other, alright? So, for example, now it's night, and this guy over here will, says avoid me, but he'll attack. He'll attack first if I go in his style. But there are some, like these biscuits. Wait. Okay, so now it's night time, and now this guy who's attacking during the night is defending during the day, so let's attack him. See? And I do damage, and I kicked his ass. And I got a card. Okay, let's attack this guy. See, he can be attacked. But because I reached him during a turn when night came, then he attacked. Alright, so we have to be careful. Some baddies attack first and others defend first. This changes between night and day. The idea is basically, in most situations, if not all, would be to attack a monster, right? When he's defending. So you do as much damage, so you do damage first, and he's going to take some damage. So if you can kill him, you'll kill him in one turn and that's it. If he can retaliate, then some, that's something else, but it will be important to just, alright. Alright, let's go here, let's kick his, kick this cookie's ass. Oh, and I got a card, wait. I got a new card, and let's attack this guy. Alright, you can tell whether a baddie's going to attack or defend by looking at the badge above their head. Alright, so okay, so I got a few cards. I can go back to my HUD and check out the cards that I got and put them in my deck. So let's see, is this one, odd slot, plus 2. Okay, so I'm gonna put them here, so I get 3 extra attack. If anyone has any questions about Loot Rascals, please please let me know in the comments. This one, card below, plus 1. Well, alright, odd slot, alright. Wait, let's try something. Alright, see, see here, if I put the card here, I get this card here, right? It's plus 2 attack, right? And I put it in an even slot, and it gave me plus 2 attack, and I went from 8 to 10. If I put it here, I will get plus 2 attack, and an extra 2, so from 10 will go to 12, and because this card up here gives an extra boost, plus 1 for the card below, I got plus 14. So I went from 8 attack to 14 attack with one card, with one single card, and depending on the position. Hi Brian, hello. So this one, let me just put it here, and we got 14 attack and 6 defense. That's really good. Now let's go attack someone. Alright, like this biscuit here. Alright, let's get the loot. Okay, avoid me. Alright. I'm going to just go around this guy until night comes. See, and I'll attack. And dead cookie. Got another loot card. Don't forget to pick up cards, open your HUD, and equip them. It's very important. As soon as you get a card, you know, just do it. Just equip it. Well, if it's good, if it's something good. Let's see what we got here. Only one. So this one will get, wait, this is plus 2 attack. Card above or below plus 2. Okay, that would be awesome. Alright, let's put it here. So I got 18 attack now. And this one will give me plus 2 defense. And if it's the only card of this type, like the blast bib, if it's the only bib, because it's not armor, it's a bib, then we'll get plus 1 extra. So I should go to defense 9. See? Defense 9. So that's pretty cool, and now my deck is complete. I can put this card in and, you know, mix and match everything. What game am I playing now? This is Loot Rascals, and it's a roguelike turn-based strategy action game, I would say, where you have to, well, defeat a lot of monsters in an alien world, basically. And you go around, you attack or you get attacked by enemies, and depending on, you know, how much attack, how much defense you have, you can defeat them. Like this cookie, I'm just going to attack it. And you'll see how the damage is done. Okay, let's try something else. Head back up where we started. Alright, let's go back. Let's go back to where we started. Again, every time I move to a new tile, one turn, you know, finished. Alright, there's a very special type of bat in here called a burn bunny. Go kill it. So that's the burn bunny. And as you can see, he's a little bit... Okay, see? He attacked me. He attacked me during the night, but I killed him because I had a lot more defense, obviously. And now I can collect the burning card. And these are special cards, which... you can see it here, this burning augmented card gives any other card the burn ability, right? Drop it in one of the equipped cards, so you can take it and put it over another card, right? So I'm going to put it over a cool one, Meteor Ball, here. And now I have a burning card, Close your HUD, and because I have the burning card, I have a new ability. I have the burning ability, and it's over here. See, it's and I can activate it. And when I activate it, I can, well, basically do a burn attack on any tile. Well, not any tile, a tile that's close to me. Click on it. Okay, so now I'll be able to head back to the biscuits. See, now I can go here and burn this tile. And then my ability will go in the cooldown. Okay. Oh, wow, it attacked me. Bugger. Alright, so now I'm going to wait until that ability is cooled. Okay. Use the mouse to move over, yeah, in combat or by stepping a charge. Okay, so I can wait until the ability is recharged, or I can go on these tiles over here, which recharge. What? Hey, ability is charged, so I can do it again. Burn. See? Alright. Whoa, the cookie attacked me. Bugger cookie. Alright. Alright, oh, it attacked me again, but I charged my ability. And now I'm going to kill these guys over here. See? Because I can't get to them, but I can use my ability to burn them. Now I just have to kind of wait it out. Nice, dead cookie. Alright, let's go charge my ability over here. Alright, ability charge, and I can go all the way back. And as you can see, it has a limited range, my ability. But I can burn this guy. And that was it. The objective is to find the exit portal in each area and use it to warp out. Find and use it now to escape this tutorial. So basically the idea is that you explore these procedurally generated worlds. And you fight enemies. You can choose to fight or avoid them depending on, you know, how much attack, how much defense you have, how much attack or defense they have, right? And you have to find the portal to go to the second world, and the third world, and the fourth world, and the fifth world, and then escape. I think the fifth world is the last one. Of course, the idea is that it just becomes harder and harder as you progress. Alright, so I have to find... where is it? I have to find the portal. I think the portal should be around down here somewhere. I haven't discovered everything. Ah, here's the portal, never mind. It just appeared here. And let's finish the tutorial. And hopefully you kind of got the idea of the game. I think it's not only a cool idea, it's easy to pick up. And you can really get into the game 15 minutes. In 15 minutes you get the basic idea of Loot Rascals and you just start playing, and it's like a roller coaster. It's like a snowball. As soon as I started playing, that was for me. As soon as I started playing, I went faster and faster and faster, and I just wanted to play and play and play. And yeah, I think it's pretty cool. Now, you can play three types of games: practice game. But I don't have a practice deck just yet for any of the areas. So I can do a seeded game if I know the seed. Because again, it's procedurally generated. And I can start a standard game, which is the single player campaign, I would say.
Wake up. Wake up. Gonna wake up.
Gonna.
We're nearly there, so I'm just going to talk you through the mission again, okay?
Okay.
Right, you're on your way to the site of a new outer space holiday camp, where the medical substance, liquid anything, has already been transported in a Big Barry unit, which is a nickname, it's got a technical name. The Big Barry should have by now prepared the planet's surface, poured in the liquid anything, and initiated the 3D rendering process. However, we've lost contact. The most likely scenario is that flying space
poor Big Barry
off the Big Barry's aerial, in which case you should load the appropriate chip into your leg mounted chip reader and use your helmet to render a replacement part. Before returning home, you should inspect the camp in case there's anything else we need to repair or replace. And remember, ensure that an area is clear before rendering in case you accidentally hit someone in the face, which can kill. This concludes the mission. Oh, sorry, nearly put you back to hypersleep there. Oh, here's the planet coming into view now, look. So I'll guide the spaceship down to the surface and you just kill.
What the hell?
I don't know what's just happened, but I do know that moon's not supposed to be there. And the bad news
is the moon.
Lost control of the ship. Oh, there's the big baddie, but his head's been stolen. Right, we're definitely gonna kill.
That wasn't that bad.
Look at this bunch of rascals. Okay, well, the new mission is let's escape.
Yep. So that's the idea of the game. In Loot Rascals, you have to escape. You have to escape and hopefully find the head of Big Barry. That's very important. All right, and that's the this is the first world, and this is kind of your hub. In each world, you have a small hub where you can go around. And let's see here. You can talk to this guy. Horrid Carlos stole my defense blender. Return it for 2 extra spare card slots. So this is kind of an NPC mission. If you get him the card back, then he'll give you, you know, 2 extra card slots, which is important if you want to carry more cards. So that's important. And here they explain the maths of combat. And the idea is this: when you attack, your attack number is subtracted from the baddie's power, right? And if he has 20 and you have 8, it goes to 12, and the idea is to kill him. Then when you defend, their power is divided by your defense, is subtracted from your health. So when an enemy attacks you, his attack, right, is divided by your defense. So 12 divided by 4, that's 3. If you have a health of 5, that means your enemy will do 3 damage, basically, and you'll be left with 2. I think it's pretty standard. Well, it's not exactly standard, it's math. It's pretty simple math, and the idea is just to have as much attack as possible so you can kill your enemies as fast as possible, and to have as much defense as possible also to avoid getting hurt. Now, even if your defense, this is important, even if your defense is higher than the baddie's power, right? So you have, if it's subtracted, it would be, well, not less than 0, I guess. It couldn't be less than 0, actually. Well, if it's 0, let's say it's 0. The chances is their power divided by defense equals 50% chance of losing one heart. So you would still be able to lose health even if your defense is higher, right? So let's see, if chance divided equals 50% chance. Okay. So that's double. Alright, but the basic idea is the more defense you have, the higher attack you have, the better you'll do, basically. That's the gist. So let's go now. Over here, I can give 2 tokens to heal myself, and you get tokens by destroying cards that you pick up. Here, let's see, examine mailbox. I don't think there's anything in the mailbox. The mailbox is where cards returned by other players or your hologram will arrive. That's important because you can actually, there's an online component to the game, and you can return cards that other players have lost, or you can choose not to do that. When that happens, I'll we'll talk a bit about that. Let's see, talk. What do we talk here? Would you like to set your practice deck for this area to your current deck? This will allow you to start a new practice game from this area with the current set. Yes, please, so I can actually start this area. Okay. And now let's get the heck out and let's start the game. Actually, start the game. Let's start the game. Alright, this guy will be attacking me. Okay, it just changed from day to night. Yeah, all baddies. Oh shit. Okay. Ah, he's attacking me! Oh, come on, I lost 1 health. Damn it. Jesus. Oh, I got a card. Ah, he attacked me! Jesus. Okay, I looted. I can attack this Ogron. Oh, come on. Okay, now he's dead. I got the card. Alright. And as you can see in the upper right, it says here in 237 turns. Well, in 237 turns, there will be a lot of enemies coming to this world. So the idea is to, if you want to survive, just find the portal to the next area as soon as possible. You can also delay the return of those or the coming of those enemies. But for now, we got a few cards, so let's mix and match our deck. Let's see, card above. Hydra Puller. Alright, let's put it here. Card above. Let's put one here and maybe one here. So I have 5 defense and 6 attack. Which is pretty good, I think, for now. And let's move. Let's move, let's discover. Okay, this is closed off. And again, all of these are procedurally generated. Ooh, fudge. Okay, this thing will attack me. Okay, I blocked it, nice. Let's just go. Oh, fuck. Oh, come on, it's attacked me. Wow, it killed me. The horse bros killed me. And when you die, you can lose... Well, technically you lose your cards, or you can lose one card or more. That's bad if you die, of course. But, death is not the end, technically. Well, it is the end, but
look,
you can restart.
Barry, it's one of your little friends. Barry's been teaching me all about this fascinating liquid he brought with him. You see, my influence over your dimension is limited. So I need representatives on the ground. I don't quite have the hang of it yet, but I'm getting close. In the meantime, we'd really appreciate it if you could keep the numbers down up there. We can't have those idiots passing Barry. Oh, and don't worry about dying. It's just a simple matter of reshuffling time. Now, back you go. Barry has so much to teach me. Your planet sounds lovely, Barry. You must show me how to get there.
Yeah, that pink thing, it's a really bad creature, I believe. And yeah, that's not good. I mean,
right,
she resurrected you, but...
a dead body for most of that, so I'll give you the upshot. There's a thing below or somewhere, and it's going to keep bringing us back to life as long as we kill the aliens around here. But what I'm thinking is, we find the big baddie head and fly it home ourselves without that thing below, obviously. So let's get looking.
Okay, so the idea is that that monster, that huge monster, although it does resurrect you, it doesn't want anything good. One second, let me just let my dog out, wait. Alright, sorry everyone, it just, she wanted out. She wanted out, if she wants out, you know, who am I to you know, comment on that? She was sleeping until 2 minutes ago, of course. She was sleeping on the bed, her head on the pillow, of course, but yeah. Alright, you're alive again. Unfortunately, the thing below can't preserve your cards when it reincarnates you. Okay, so the idea is that you start from the beginning, you have, you know, no cards, or at least you lose all the cards that you got. So let's start from the beginning. Alright. This thing is kind of annoying. Okay, let's kill it. Alright, let's kill this thing now. Nice. Oh, give me that card. Give me that card. That's a meteor ball plus 1 attack. That's good. Alright, that thing is annoying. But it will... It's scared of me, so... Oh, I didn't get anything? Really? Oh, come on. Come on, Whiskers. Fudge. That guy is coming after me. Oh, I got a new card. Right. Nice. Okay. Nice, I killed it. Let's check the cards. Card to the right plus 1. Ooh, alright. Let me put... It's a cool, it's a pool beast. It's a pool beast and it gives me 2 attack. And also plus 1 to the top card to the right. So now I have 8 attack. Which is pretty good, I think. Alright, let's discover. Oh, this is Bolus Gal. This is someone who, well, I don't know, it's just dead now. Oh, come on, attack me, biatch. Whoa, what the hell is this thing? Oh, a clunker. Huh, interesting. Interesting, very, very interesting. Whoa, Ogrox. This guy has 17 defense. That's a lot. Okay. That is a lot, and this thing will come after me, see? What the hell? Attack it! And run! Come on, how many clunkers are... No, this is not a demo, this is the full build. Well, it's a review build. But no, it doesn't have a demo. It does not have a demo. Okay, so I kill all that. I got this car, which is other meteor balls plus one, which is pretty cool. So 13 attack. Okay, let's just go. These guys are annoying. They really piss me off because they run away from me. Alright, what does this do? Card above or below, plus one. Alright, let me put this one here and this one here. So I have 14 attack. I don't have a lot of defense, that's the problem. Okay, dude, die. Let's go see here. Oh, never mind, dead end. Oh, come on. And I died again. You're really low on health. This could be a good time to return to the dome and spend some tokens on the healing machine. You can warp back to the dome by holding Q. Well, I'm not going to do that. I am going to... Oh, come on, another one? Fudge. Oh, come on. That's really crap. Look at that. Look how many. Look how many. There are like two of them. Two clunkers. That's really shit, actually. That is shit. Because there's so many. It's like you have to kill everyone. Ow. I'm actually die. And I died. Damn it, that was really bad. That was bad. And I'm going to lose a card. Actually, more than one card, apparently. Oh, come on. Actually, no, it doesn't matter. Oh, okay, so all of those cards are stolen. They are stolen from me by monsters. Okay, wait. Yeah, I went back. So, when you die, monsters steal the card, some cards from you. And then those monsters can come in other players' game, and they can find my cards. And if they return my cards, that's awesome. If they don't, then they're bastards. I don't know what to say. Shit. Lucky for me, this guy is like super slow. The Ogron. Oh. Okay, no card, unfortunately. Oh, nighttime is the best time. Ooh, a new card. Let's see, this is card above or below plus two. Alright, nice. Let me put it here and this. I get some extra attack in here. Nice, dead. And I got, oops, wait, what did I get? What's this? What is this? Bottom row plus two. Okay, so this one gives me plus one attack, but if it's on the bottom row, right, then I'll get an extra two attack, so that's three attack, which is really good, I think. Oh, come on. Ow. Biatch. Okay. Whiskas, bitch. Okay, it attacked me. Oh, I lost one health. Jesus. Alright. And this is other bibs. Okay, I have other bibs. Plus one. Cards to left. Minus one. Alright. So, wait. So, this, in order for this one to work, I need to put it all the way to the left. Yay! And I got 8 defense now. That's pretty cool. That's pretty good. Alright, Ogron. Come on, dude. Kill you. Nice. Ooh, I got a new car, which is abilities charge faster. I don't have any abilities though, so you have to actually have to find the car. Oh, come on. Wait. The thing I don't understand is like, will this continue to spawn like enemies forever and ever? Cause that's something I don't understand. Alright. Let's just go. Oh, come on. Shit. Oh. Oh. Oh crap, he will attack me. This guy will attack me. Oh, look, that's the portal. That is the portal, I believe. I think that's the portal. Or I get a card? Oh no, I get a card. All baddies are confused. Nice. Okay, all baddies are confused, and this is like a full card. So I can put it against, I don't know. All baddies are confused. Well, I would like them to be confused, so let's put it here. Oh, wow. That's really shit. Because I can't really move properly. Alright. Oh, come on. I pretty much went to a freaking corner. You know what I don't like? That it feels... apparently, this thing will spawn enemies continuously. Which I really think it's crazy. Or maybe I need to do something to it? I don't know. Look how many clunkers. It's either a bug or I don't know what the hell. Maybe I need to destroy something, but it's not like the game is telling me anything. So, I don't know. I really don't know what the hell to do. I mean, look how many! It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Is this normal? Because it doesn't feel normal to me. It feels like wrong. Like problematic wrong. Like very, 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 very wrong. Okay, I lost another health. And I died again. Now this is weird. See, it's gonna steal my car. This is really odd. It's like, if I go on any of those platforms, there will be like enemies respawning, like spawning ad infinite. I really don't understand that. Maybe it's a bug. Maybe I need to do something. I don't know. That's weird. But it definitely feels wrong. Wrong. It definitely feels wrong. Definitely feels wrong. Very, very, very wrong. Huh? 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 Okay, so oh, come on, die. Ah, Jesus, it took one health. Card of love plus one, only 1-0. Oh, okay, never mind then. Never mind then. Oh, shit. Bada bada. Kill you. Come on, die. Dead, nice. Okay, got a new card. Oh, come on! Oh, so crap! Alright, let's loot this. And what do we have? We have card above below, plus one. Let's put it here. Let's put the bib here. Another bib here. And this one here. Okay, so it does give me plus one. Whew. Oh, it's only nighttime now. What? Alright, something happened. And it's now perpetual night. Oh, it was perpetual night. Oh, this guy, look. So when I come close to him, it's always night, I think. Very interesting. Come on. Oh, come on. I got killed by the horse bros again. Jesus. All right, that's freaking difficult. That's pretty crap. Yeah, I died. Many times. All right. Oh, wait, I don't want to go here. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. No. Oh, that was stupid of me. I went in the... That was really dumb. Okay, I got two more cards, ability to charge faster, and yeah, right. Now let's look around. Okay, this is pretty closed off. Die, thank you. Come on. Freaking, oh, what we got? We got a card, Vortex Bin Lid, and it gives me plus two defense, which is cool, I guess. Not bad. Now, let's see. Whoa. This guy has... Oh, come on! How did he turn? Wait, I died again. How did he turn from defense to attack? This is odd. I mean, of course, it depends on the enemy, but... crap. Come on. Wow, I die so fast. Okay. Oh, come on, die. Die, dude. Hey, got a card, which does... Card below plus one. In column one, okay. Well, let's go for extra defense, maybe. Hello, monster. What? Oh, come on. I still lost health. Jesus. Only one plus two. Nice. I have nine attack now. That's pretty good. All right. Let's go around here. Let's see if we can find something. Nice. Come on, dude. Come here. Oh. Kill you. Yes. I kill you and I got... An extra two defense. Ooh. Voila. Vole. Nice. Come on, come here. Pussy, come here. Whoa. That guy has 13 attack. Nice. What do we get? Card below plus one? Sure. Actually, wait. Maybe I can... See? For example, I didn't check. I could put this one here and get even more Actually, no, wait. It's still one. Wait. Why? Why is this still just... Wait. So this one gives me one defense... And this one gives me two, so why is it not doubled? 2 plus 1 is 3, and this one... Wait, that's impossible! Wait. In column 1, 0. Rotate? Oh, I can rotate. It's like a double card with a bonus for defense or for attack. All right. Well, what this is weird. Maybe it's a bug. So okay. So this one it gives me two defense, right? If I don't have it, it's okay. Two defense plus one. So that's five plus three, eight. Three, two from this one and an extra one from this one. So okay. So these are pretty much the same card, except this one gets. So why doesn't give me nine? It should be. So this is five, right? Plus two, seven, plus one, eight. What? Why does it work like that? That's odd. Oh, because it doesn't matter, because it doesn't double anything. Sorry, it doesn't double anything. It just gives me one plus one extra. Okay, it doesn't. I was thinking that it would double the card below, but it doesn't. Sorry. Card below plus one. Well, let's just go for defense, I guess, a little bit. All right, now. Yeah, I was thinking that it would be. Come here. Come here, little guy. Okay, that's good. He's dead. Freaking Whiskas. Screw you, dude. So see, alright, I don't understand this shitty thing. It's like it will continue to spawn stuff until forever and ever and ever and ever. Alright, so I got a card which this one drag into another card to give it the filth ability. When charged, you'll be able to teleport. So let's go here. Okay. All right, I got this. Let's teleport. Wait, let's loot. Let's teleport here so I can attack this guy. Nice! Freaking Whiskas. All right. All right. Whoa, hello. This guy is always coming after me. See, but. Alright, let's loot and check the cards. Okay, so we have this one plus one. I have already trousers that are plus one. This one, card to the right, plus one. So, it doesn't really matter, right? So let's just put it here. That's 10, 8, 9. Okay, right, 10. 10 attack, good. Now let's just move forward. Okay, this one's a closed area. Let's check the map. See? This is everything I discovered. Hello. Oh, wow, it actually hurt me, bastard. Run. Run from the ogre. Okay, he's dead now. Okay, kill them. No, Whiskas. Hello, the severe Benjamin. Oh, severe Benjamin, really? Okay, I can't teleport, unfortunately. Wow, this guy has a lot of defense. Wow, but I still defeated him. Nice. Oops. Okay, let's loot. And this car used to belong to Ranoka before this rascal stole it from them. So Ranoka is another player, another Loot Rascals player. Would you like to send it back to them? Yes. Actually, no, I'm gonna keep it. I'm going to keep it and I'm going to teleport here. Nice. Okay, so let's go back and let's see the card that we got. So this one is bottom row minus two, only one bib. Alright, wait one second. Let me put this one here. Put this one back. So, only one. If there's only one bib for defense. 13, and let's see, card below, huh, 9, let's keep it like that, let's keep it like that. Okay, so I still haven't found, oh, can I teleport? I can't teleport yet, never mind. Ow. Oh, I'm almost dead. That's not good. That is not good. That is definitely not good. So, I say we go back to the hub, right? What is the yellow cyclops? Is that bone, what? The yellow cyclops? Oh, no, it's just another enemy. I think he's holding a bone. Yeah, I think he's holding like a huge bone. But it's just a cyclops. Okay, so this one, let me decompile this card and get the money for it. And this one, see, I get tokens, all right? And why can't I? Oh, okay. So you can warp back to the dome, and I want to warp back in order to get my health back up. But it will take 25 turns though to get here and back. But you can warp right back, okay. But it will also cost you turns. Well, that's fine. It would cost me turns anyway. Alright, so I heal myself. Here you give 2 tokens in order to heal yourself fully. And now I say let's go back. Let's warp back to where we came from. Alright, and let's go try to find that freaking teleport thingy. Ah, crap. Oh, phew, I didn't die. That's good. That is good. Okay, there's nothing here. No enemy? Come on. Ooh, horse bros. Die, horse bros. Nice. I like it when they die. Oh, alright. Senior. Oh, let me teleport. So I can kill this guy. See, I'm using my ability. I'll teleport. So I'll attack him. Whoa! Alright, he's dead. And these Ogrocks, I'm just going to go back. Because they have 17 and 18 attacks. So I don't want to fight them, really. Okay, let's attack them now. Ow, see? They're tough. They're tough bastards. And I lost 2 health, but I defeated both of them. And I got 2 cards. Let's see. Card below. Card below plus 1. This one. Other insect boots. Plus 1. Insectoid boots. Oh, this is better. This is definitely better. Get more defense. And this one. Plus 2 attack instead of 1. Alright. Let's put it here. And let's decommission some of the cards here. These maybe. Decompile, sorry. These ones are low level, they're low energy, very low energy. Okay, I want to see what's here. Alright, so there's a guy here. Bola, bola? Bola, bola? Bola, okay, go stay there then. Bola, bola? Bolas, gal. Okay, let's see if there's anything here left. Okay, there's nothing here. You can check the map from time to time, so basically I can go here and here. I haven't discovered stuff here. Wait, okay. Ooh, what's this? That's another player. That was a... Thanks for sending back my owner's card. So that's the hologram of a player, I guess? Okay. Oh, and he comes after me, and he's going to help me. Whoa, what the fudge is that? Shit. Okay. Okay, let me kill this guy first. Jesus. Alright, wait. Let's loot. Ow. Oh, look, it's helping me. Nice. Alright, so I got this one. Car below plus one. I already have that stuff. Alright. Is that thing dancing? I'm not sure which thing you're talking about. It probably is, yes. Alright, wait. Okay, let's attack it. And let's try to teleport. Let's try to teleport here. Okay, that was a bad idea, because he can attack me, no? Ow. Oh, never mind, it worked, it's fine. Alright. Ow. Bastard. Okay, let's attack this guy. They may be dancing, yeah. Why not? They may actually be dancing. Mean Johnny. This is Mean Johnny. I shouldn't have attacked him, I guess. Oh, I got a card. Let's see. This one got quest card. Return to the chef. So I got a card that if I send 3 tokens to fully charge. Okay. Alright, well, is that like the teleporter? What the fuck? Ventrigon. Ow! Ah, I got another card! Nice! Which is a pink card! Okay, I got a new ability with this one. And I can heal myself. Okay. Nice. I think... Oh no! You've been here for a while now and corpse mites are starting to show up. If you hang around even longer, even worse things will appear. You can see how many turns until the corpse crew arrive in the top right below the turn counter. Okay, so because I've been here for too long, there's some corpses that appeared. But I think this is the platform? I think this is the teleporter? So let's go here. Warp to the next area, yes, yes, we finished the first area, yes, finally. Woo, journal completion, and the beginning fails of dank worms, whatever that means. So see, I'm now in the second world, there are like 5 worlds, and at the last one you'll be able to find, I guess you'll be able to find a big Barry's head, and maybe fight that huge monster that resurrects you, and... you know, that's how you finish the game, I guess. Alright, so now we're in zone 2. Let's see, zone 2. I have 3 out of 5 health. I should probably heal myself. So let's go in here, let's heal. Wait, first, let's see the cards. Okay, this one I'm going to destroy. Card below... actually, wait, what am I doing? Nah, it's the same, right? Yeah, the same stuff. Never mind, because there are 2 bibs. Never mind. Bottom row minus 2. Okay, let me put this one. I'm going to destroy this one. Decompile. Let's decompile this one. And heal myself, yes? Oh, and I think it takes more tokens depending on what level you are. Okay, got that. Night Wizard. He's a night wizard. Oh crap. Okay, let's teleport to this guy and kill him. Surprise, motherfucker! Nice, I killed him! And I got the card, which is... just a shitty card, just plus 1 attack. Never mind. Never mind. Oh, hello, Snark Pants? This is Snark Pants. See? Snark Pants. A lot of health. A lot of defense, actually. Okay, see, this is ice, and if I go on it, I think I'll slip. So, let's try not to... what the fudge is this thing? Okay. Let's avoid that. Let's avoid these things. Oh, fudge. Uh, Nice! See, I killed one. Whoa, 35! Are you shitting me right now? This guy has 35 defense. Are you kidding me right now? Wow. That's really bad. Oh, come on. I lost 2 health already. Wow, that was crazy. That was freaking crazy. This one, card above, plus 1. Other binlands. Okay, 16 compared to 14. Okay, that's pretty good. Let me decompile this one. Alright. So, yeah, that was pretty bad. But what can I do now? Well, I could teleport if I find something. Die! Ow! Die! Ow, I lost 1 health. And it's dead. What the fudge is that thing? Card above, card below. Alright, so I'm going to decompile this one. Okay, and check this out. See this thing? I don't know what the hell that thing is, but... What the hell? Ow. Okay, I should teleport on that one. Ooh, narc pants. Okay. Okay, snark pants. Oh, fudge. Nice, I killed the snark pants. Whew, right. So, let's go back. Alright, it's pretty crazy. I don't like the ice, because you slip on the ice. Okay, so this is done. And I really want to teleport. See, that thing is running away from me. And if I could teleport... What is that? Choira Obscura. What the hell is this thing? Oh, I heal myself for 1, nice. See, that's bad. You slip. Okay, there's nothing there. All right. Egg General. Ow! Ah, killed the Egg General. Nice. I killed him. Ooh, congrats on beating that world. Yeah, it's, you know what? You can get quite lucky, I guess, and you can finish it pretty fast. I was pretty unlucky the previous times, but yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, the explosion. Well, it can damage you too. That's the thing. So you have to stay away. Okay, let's kill the one here. Kill it. Nice. Deja. Freaking ogre. Can I use this? I can't use it yet. Oh, okay. Well, that guy's 15. What the hell is this thing? Look! I don't know what the hell that thing is, but... Oh, heal, right click to trigger, okay. Hey, I healed myself! Okay. Ah, oh, this little guy. Ah, see, I lost 1 health. Take out the Eggman. Alright, so let's see what we got. Let's see what we got here. We got this one. Plus 3 and cards to left. Plus 2. Cards to left plus 2. Well, I could put this one on. Wait. I could put this thing on here. This card will be stuck in the slot until decompiled. Are you sure? No. Oh, it's a sticky one. It's a sticky card. Okay, well, okay, let's make it. Because it will give card to the left plus 2, which means even plus 2 attack. Why didn't I get plus 2 attack? Only 1. That's odd. That is odd why I didn't get more attack. That is odd, I think. Okay, let's decompile this one. That is odd. I really don't know why I got that one. Webjack. So I guess Webjack just puts down webs. Blah, 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 blah. See? Okay, he puts down webs. And he's going to kill me, probably. Oh no, he didn't kill me yet. I think I should teleport right now, because I have like only one health left. So let's go back. Oh, I can't, because I'm near baddies. Okay, let's turn. Let's go back. Whew, right. Hello. Can I help you? Okay, I didn't find... Ooh, what the hell? Thief lure. Viceroy Henry of Kanta stole my thief lure. Return it for a reveal map card. That's pretty cool. That kind of looks like a vibrator, but yeah, anyway. All right. Oh, see, and now it takes 8 tokens. It takes 8 tokens to heal yourself. That's kind of crap that you need so many stuff. I mean, I only get one. Oops, sorry, continue. I only get one token per card, which is really shit if you think about it. Getting so few cards. Is that guy 48? Are you kidding me? He's 48. Come on, that is crazy. Viceroy Henry of Kanta. Yeah, he's 40 freaking 8. Can you believe that shit? He is 48. He has 48 attack. Oh, I found something. Loot, what's this? A mysterious artifact. Well, anything that gives me health, please. This one... What the hell is this thing, though? A mysterious artifact. Alright. Alright. Fuck. And I died. I died because of the freaking, you know, the ice. Jesus. Jesus. Oh, crap. Okay. I died. To start from the beginning. Jesus. Come on. Same cards. What the fuck? Come on! Quit. Start a standard game, alright? Jesus. I like how the first monster already takes one health from me. Jesus. Alright, this one is a pool beast plus 2 attack. Cool. Hello, Ogron. Ah, nice, another one down. This one is, if it's an even slot, plus 1, so I get plus 3. Nice, plus 3 defense, that's pretty cool. Yeah? Oh, whoa. Bula bula. They all talk like aliens, actually. Let's see, what have I got? Card below plus 1, even slot 0. Wait, so let's put it like that. Hey, nice, that's better. So now this one's plus 1, and that's nice, okay. That's pretty good, I think. Hola! Hola, hola! Ow! Oh, it actually says that, like, bala bala! Bala? Bala bala! Ooh, what card is that? Attack me, come on, Whiskas? Oh, come on, I can't believe I lost one health from the freaking Whiskas. Alright, let's loot this. I got a second chance? Second chance on death. Okay, that's cool. So if I die, I will live. What the fudge is this thing? Ah, shit. Ah, come on, I missed it. I missed the thingy. Alright, dead. Okay, can someone fucking tell me what the fudge is going on with this shit? Cause this is kinda shit, by the way. Like, it's like... Okay, I guess I deactivated it. I guess. Okay, ogre. That's a bomb here. Nice. Die, ogre. And give me that card. Give me that. All cards left and right plus one. Ah, interesting. Well. Okay, let's do a little shuffling. Put this one here and this one. All right, 7-9. All right. Come on, Whiskers. Whoa, Horse Bros. Whoa, so many enemies. Jesus. Come on, horsey. Die. Oh, come on, fucking... fucking shitty Whiskers. That's so crap. See, it runs away from me, but... oh, Jesus, that's annoying. Alright, I only have like one health left, so... fudge. Oh, come on, see? It pressed on this thing again. And I can't even go to it. I can't even attack it properly. That's really shit. What the fuck? Spectral Bride. Okay, that's new. That's new. The Spectral Bride. Ooh, I got a new card. Which does... when charged up, you will be able to create Spectral Decoy. Alright. Hmm. Alright, Spectral Decoy. And this one is... Taunt. Aww. See, it's attacking them! Fucking Whiskers. I wish I could kill all of them. Fuck. I'm going to die. Horse Bros. Oh crap. You know what, Horse Bros? Suck it. If I die, I die. I died. Never mind. I mean, they had 12 defense, so yeah, that was pretty difficult. Oh no! Sorry, I didn't die. Wait, I didn't die. Never mind. Never mind. I didn't die yet. So this one gives me plus one. Okay, let's decompile this one and this one. And car below plus two. Okay. Nice. Alright, and let's teleport back, probably. I should teleport back. Yeah, the thing is that it takes quite a bit of time for your abilities to charge up, you know? Okay, so every time you heal yourself, the price for healing goes up. Alright, so that's kind of shit. That is kind of shit, actually. Bala bala. Bala? Alright. Freaking Whiskers. What the fuck? Grabbler. What? Oh, it killed me. So the grabbler killed me and got one of my cards, I guess? Oh, it didn't kill me, but it grabbed one of my cards, anyway. Alright, that's odd. Ole. 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 Come on, where's the freaking teleporter? Okay. Holos. Holos. Okay, kill it. Nice. Oh, come on. Really? What's this? Card above plus one. Card above plus one. Okay, let's put it like this. Alright. Hello. 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 Oh, look, the card. Alright, so I found... Just a normal card, this one with the commission. And, but this one, this is the card that I have to give for my mission. Oops, sorry. That was one of my missions. So now I could take it back. Alright. Okay, so there's nothing here. Wait, let's check the map. So I could go back and then go down here. Maybe I can find the teleporter here. So let's go back. Okay, so right now those alien, the corpses have started coming. Which is bad because that just means more enemies. Manual, oh, that wasn't it. Wait. So this one always steals this. Oh. Okay, so never mind, that was a mistake from my mind. See this? And now we have these shits around. I kind of wish the game would make it so you have a bit more time to go around. A bit more freaking time to go around before anything is like, oh. Alright. But do those guys move? Okay, so that's... I don't think they move. Okay, that's the thing with them. At least they don't move, but still. Okay, there's nothing here. Okay. Oh, but no, they do attack you. So that's kind of shit. Because there's so many of them, you know? Alright. That's really shit. I mean, sometimes, you don't have enough time to go and find the freaking, you know, it really, sometimes you don't have the time, and it really pisses me off that you, oh, see all of this, this, I just wasted my time, I wasted turns, just to go here, and there's nothing here. I hope there're going to be fixes on this thing, because I don't like that, it's stupid. And of course I'm going to get killed by things that are so much tougher than me, you know? And look, like, I went back once, right? So that's 50 turns. And look, I've explored quite a bit, but still it wasn't enough. I mean... Yeah, see, still, that still wasn't enough. That still wasn't enough. Look at all of this thing. Like this, I don't even know what this does. Okay, that's a player hologram, I guess. Loot Recharge Hollow 1. Okay. Let me... Ah, see, this guy doesn't go away from here. Yeah, I'm going to die. Yes, the maps are random, and you teleport by just pressing and hold Q, and you teleport back to the dome, and you can teleport back to where you came from, like to the dome and back. Spend the token to recharge your companion hollow. Well, I don't have any of that, and the thing is, you don't have enough turns in a lot of times in order to freaking finish, not even finish, like even check part of the fucking map. You know, that's annoying. I mean, sure, I was reincarnated, but it's useless because I had a card. I had a card that gave me one. But look how much I uncovered, right? In about, what, 300? I think, kind of 300 turns. And I still haven't found a portal to the next level. So it's either you're lucky or you're dead. And I don't like that luck part so much. I mean, I think you should get more turns until these shits come about. Look at these shits. They're all here and they all have so much, you know, attack and defense. And you don't have anything because, yeah. Why would you have anything? You're just weak. And of course, you become weaker and weaker as, you know, time goes by. As, yeah, see again, I barely got out of the dome and I lost one health. And then there's this shit with 26 defense. And you can't really avoid them. And I lost two health. And I lost another health. And I barely made it, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 4 turns away from the dome. And I'm already as good as dead, you know. Which I think it's shit. I think it's really shit. I think it's not fair. Cause I can't deal with any of these. It's impossible to deal with them. It is virtually impossible. So it's either you're fucking lucky and you find the fucking portal to the next area, or you're dead. So I think there's some balancing that needs to be done over here. I think there's some balancing that needs to be done. Because I've explored plenty. I've explored plenty and I haven't found the shit. I mean, is it my fault? That's just... No. Alright, so I got a sticky. Ooh, card to the right, plus one. Alright, let's sticky. Yes. Card to the left, plus one. Alright, nice. Okay. So there's nothing there. At least I know that. So it's quite a bit of luck required for this, all of this. Hello, Whiskers. Holy. Die. Okay, loot. What did I get? I got a plus one attack. That's good. And dead. Nice. Let's go up. I wish you could trap the fucking Whiskers somewhere. Because they really pissed me off. Oh, and that thing... Okay, of course it passed on... Oh, shit. Even slot, and... Okay. Anyone? Oh crap. Oh shit, I lost one health. That was bad. Oh, a card, okay. What did I get? What did I get? Was this? All abilities boosted from standing on suppressor tiles. What are suppressor tiles? That would be nice to know. What's that? What is your suppressor tile? Come on. Nothing? Okay, dead end. So dead end here, I can only go, okay. Fucking shitty Whiska. Alright, they really pissed me off. Card above, plus one. Let's go with here. Alright, let me decompile this one. Alright, so. Wait, where do I go? Okay. They ran like... And they come back because they're like so tough, you know? Oh, come on, nothing here. I mean, look how many turns I already... Alright. Bolas. Okay. Whoa, ow. Bolas. Card above, plus one, yes. Nice. I got quite... Very little defense, though. Okay. Die, dude. Come on, anyone here? Hello? Oh, come on, nothing here, okay. Okay, wait, I got the health one here? Oh, Egg General! Oh! Okay, he's dead. I got... Well, I can decommission this one. Alright. I mean, look at this! I'm wasting time right now, right? Having to fucking go after a shitty creature that doesn't have the fucking guts to come and attack me. You know? Because it really doesn't have the guts. Okay, what did I get? This one is spend 5 tokens to detonate a huge bomb. Oh, alright, I don't have 5 tokens, okay. Alright. Okay. Okay. Fucking Bolas. Die. Nice. Is it like Bolas? Oh, Lus! Ow. What's that? This car used to belong to Flick before the Rascals stole it from them. Would you like to send them back? Yes, send it back to them. So I'm sending it back to players that have lost that. Oh, come on, Bolas! Oh, Lus! Ow! Bitch. What do we have? This is an other beast plus one. Odd slot zero. What the fuck? What just happened? Oh, never mind. Alright, let's put it here. Nice! 15 attack! Motherfucker, come here. See? He puts the stuff here. Alright. Bitch. Oh, never mind. I healed myself. That's good. Alright. Let's kill this guy. I mean, look at that. I didn't go back to the base, to the hub, and I've uncovered quite a few, and I only have like 66 turns left. That's 66 moves. That's not a lot. That is really not a lot. Oh crap, I lost. Okay, that's bad. Oh, and I found the fucking dead end. Great. Alright, this is burn ability places bombs. Okay, I don't have the burn ability, so never mind. I have quite a few cards that I don't have anything to do with them. So right now, for example, I can do two things. Either I can go all the way around here, or yeah, I guess that's the cheapest thing. But I'm just wasting a lot of time, you know. I'm wasting a lot of time. How was I supposed to know that this was a dead end? If I knew, I wouldn't have went here. I really wouldn't. And that pisses me off. That, you know, it's like you don't get any chance to do anything. Fucking Bola. Shh, okay. Alright. Loot, yes. What do we got? Only one. Sure. 16, nice. And let's decompile this one. And I guess it should be around here somewhere. I don't know where, but it should be. Okay. Alright, that thing will come after me. Okay, dead. Let's loot this. Which is abilities charge faster. That's cool, actually. Let's put it here. Decommission this thing. And... Senior. Alright. I mean, the horse bro's fine. Block, good. Wait, what did I get? In column, 1 plus 1. Oh, 3, whoa. Alright, good. And this one, 2. No. Nah, it's already 1 here. Yeah, let's decommission it. Alright. I mean, that's the problem, right? Look how much I've discovered, and I still couldn't be fast enough, right, in order to not have that crap thing activate. Crap. And that really pisses me off, you know? Okay, so this is a dead end here, I guess. Alright. Okay, another card. Let's heal. I like that it only heals one. Why don't I get healed for like 5? Jesus. This one no longer slip on ice tiles, walking on ice costs no turns. That's cool. But, yeah. It's not going to be for this world. Ah, see, dead end. Okay, so look how much I've searched. Look how much I've searched, and it was still not enough. And now these shits appear here. And I can't avoid them, and I have to fight them, you know? And I think that's really... That's... Scoozy Port Witch, okay. Oh, shit. Okay. Ow. It attacked me. Whoa. Alright, let's check the HUD. This one, this will charge something. Okay, let's go to... Let's try this one. So, only one, bottom row zero. Okay, let me decommission this one. Oops. Wait, oh, sorry, not... oh, come on, not E, R, Jesus. Alright, so I destroyed this one, and now I have a new ability, which is... What, to shock people? Oh, I can zap them, alright. And look, I still haven't found the freaking teleporter to the next base. I mean, come on. A little bit of help here. It's a little bit of, you know. Jesus. Wait. This one in column 1 plus 2 Ascrit. I mean, look, it was exactly at the end, like the opposite side of the map, and it took me so many turns to find it. Whew, the game should give you more turns before those nasties come about, you know? General completion, 39%. I don't know what that means, general completion. Like, in terms of what I found? All right, so we're back here. We're again on this one. You know what? It would be cool for your health to be recharged after you go to the second world. That would be nice. That would be a little bit of help. A little bit. Just a little. Just a tiny bit of help. Just a tiny, 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 tiny bit. That would be nice. That would tiny bit. Just a tiny bit. You know, just very tiny. A little bit. Oh shit. Oh, I should have zapped them. Oh, I zapped them, nice! And I got the card, which is plus 3 even slot. Okay. This one has to go. Wait, what's. Oh, no, never mind. Whoa! Egg General.
Yeah.
Okay. So since we are here, let's sacrifice something. Ooh, wait. 18. Wait. Can I sacrifice something that doesn't? 7. Okay, I'll take this one. All right. I think. All right. So now I no longer. Slip on ice, and it doesn't take any turns when I go on ice. So that's pretty cool, actually. Okay, so I just found that there's nothing here. That's always good to find. What the hell? Grabbler. I zapped it. I zapped the biatch. Cramphibian. Ah, crap. What this top row 3? Seventeen ten. All right. Okay. Wait. I can change this. Put it back. 18 11. Yes. Oh, look at this guy, Lunk. Jesus. I mean, of course I'm going to die like this, you know? Wait, let me zap this thing. Ah, and I died. And I died, I died, I died, I died, I died. And the freaking Bride of Frankenstein got one of my cards. Or two of my cards, never mind. You know, I figure it'd be really cool if you had more turns before those enemies appear, before those corpses appear. So it's 250 turns. It would be cool if it was like 300, with 300 turns and then, you know, 50 after that and, you know, something like that. But, and other than that, I don't know, like... more health? How can you get more health? You don't get a lot of cards that give you something like that. So it'd be cool to have more health, cheaper refills for your health, for example, because it costs what, double? It costs double every time. It's like two tokens, and then it's four tokens, and then it's eight tokens. How about it's 2, 4, 6, 8? Because it's already expensive. It's not like you're going to find a billion cards, you know. It's not like you're going to find a billion cards to just destroy them. You, for the most part, you want to keep a lot of the cards that you find. It's not like you're going to be, you know, a rich man with a billion tokens and you can always go back to your base and you know, recover, because you wouldn't want to go back to your base anyway, because it takes 25 turns there and back. So yeah, so I think there's still a few things that I would like tweaked, at least I would like tweaked, but for the most part I like the idea, and I think Loot Rascals is a pretty cool game. I just think it's in order to be a bit more, to seem a bit more fair, I think it just needs, you know, a little bit of tweaking. Not sure about what other people who play it say, but that's my view, that's my view on it. I would still you know, recommend, you know, you checking it out. It is coming on March 7th, so just less than a week from now, like, what, 5 days. It comes out for Steam, for Windows, and it's probably going to be, like, $14.99 with maybe a launch discount. And it's also coming for the PlayStation 4, so whoever has a PlayStation 4, this one will be available on that platform too. Not sure about Linux or Mac versions. For now, it's Windows and the PS4. PS4, PS4 Pro, PS4 Slim, all they're all the same. Well, not exactly, but yeah. So again, everyone, this is Loot Rascals from Hollow Ponds Games, coming March 7th, coming to you live March 7th. And yeah, I'm guessing I'm gonna try to make some smaller videos to showcase the game, and maybe finish, because it take, you know, the thing is, it can take quite a lot to finish a map. So we'll have to see, but I definitely want to make a smaller video to showcase it, because it's a cool concept. It's definitely a cool concept. So thanks everyone for watching. If you like this live stream, then please give it a thumbs up. And if you like the other content that I put on the channel, like for example other gameplay videos or other live streams, gameplay videos, developer interviews, walkthroughs even, then please click on the subscribe button and check out the channel a bit later today. As in next half hour or something, because I'm going to upload a gameplay video of a game that is on green light right now. Hopefully you'll like it and maybe vote for it. Thanks again everyone for watching. Again, tell your friends, family, enemies, if anyone has enemies in 2017. Probably, maybe. I don't know. I never got that thing with enemies. And yeah, let's go to 500 subscribers. Soon, hopefully before I, you know, 1 year, before the channel is 1 year old. So thanks again everyone for watching, and I'll see you again very soon, tomorrow, new live stream of course. Until the next time we see each other, Friday, obviously on Friday, thank you and have an awesome day.